Hi, my name's Becky and I'm making this video from Australia. This is a testimonial video about the incredible work that Becky did for us last night. So this is Coco, and Coco is a pregnant mama that I am fostering until she has her babies. And then she'll hopefully be rehomed to a beautiful home, and her babies will also find adopted homes. And last night, Saturday night, she escaped out my front door. Just an unfortunate moment where the door was just open just a little too long, and I have pets of my own, and there was a bit of commotion at the door, and suddenly she was out and gone. So we followed her out. She ran off down the driveway. Probably the worst thing we did was chase her, but she crossed over the street, which gave me a heart attack in itself, and my husband saw her jump the fence of an across the street neighbor into their backyard. That neighbor had two small dogs, pug dogs, so Mama was okay. I imagine she bolted for height, maybe up a tree or something like that. But we then spent the next good hour, 2 hours, looking for her, and it got dark. So she escaped probably around 6:30, 7 o'clock. My husband ended up going back to the house, and I periodically did more walks of the neighborhood. So probably every hour or so, I did two or three more walks, three walks I think it was, around the neighborhood, calling Coco's name. Had no luck, and one of the walks during the night, I spotted numerous other cats. I think I saw three more other cats, and none of them were her. So by this time, I'm devastated, especially as a foster parent. I really felt like I had let her down, and let the babies down, and really didn't know what would become of her. She is an outside cat. She came from a small town outside of the city where I live. So she was completely used to being outdoors, and she probably would have been quite fine, but that may not have been the case for her babies. So in a desperate bid, I looked up pet psychics, and Becky came up with a Facebook ad with amazing testimonials, and I guess the one that sort of led me to definitely contact her was the story of here we go. Hi, Mama. There she goes. She's off for a wander around. But the story of the dog that Becky had been able to find in Australia. So I contacted Becky by Messenger, Facebook Messenger, and asked for her assistance. She was absolutely amazing and was able to give me some details that led to Coco being found. Now, specifically, she said to me I needed to be looking in gardens, which was very hard because I'm in a neighborhood and everybody has gardens. But, you know, that didn't deter me. I at least was happy maybe she wasn't under a house or something like that. And Becky said to me, she saw gardens, trees, something blue and pink flowers. And then weirdly, she said to me about white railings. And it was funny, something just clicked in me because she had said white railings and not white palings, not fence palings. And she had also said to me that she thought Coco was 2 to 4 houses down from ours on the left, down on the left, so down the street. And weirdly, I was just sitting there and the house on the corner popped into my head, and it has a white railing metal fence. And I thought, okay, I'm going down, I'm going for a look. I walked down the street. This is now 1 a.m. I walked down the street, and as I went down, I was calling Coco's name, nothing, nothing, nothing. I got right to that house on the corner and called out Coco, and Coco went meow, and there she was. And I was just absolutely incredulous. I couldn't believe it. I was absolutely ecstatic and overjoyed. We had a little bit of trouble getting her back. I phoned my husband. I had my phone with me, and I phoned him. He was asleep by this stage. He came down. We had to jump the fence into this neighbor's yard. Thankfully, nobody seemed to be home. Hopefully, we didn't scare anybody in the neighborhood. He brought with him some food, a tin and a spoon. So we made tinny noises and rattling noises. She finally came over, let us pet her, tried to eat some food, and my husband grabbed her. He passed her over the fence to me, and I wrapped her in my coat, and we were able to get her home safe and sound. So here she is. I would just like to say the biggest thank you to Becky. The relief that I felt being able to help this mama and her babies and not have them out in the cold. It's just turned spring here in Australia. But you know, the nights are still cool, and having babies, newborn babies out there, just the thought of it broke my heart. Thank you, Becky, for the work that you did. I don't know what forces brought us together, for me to find you and for you to find Coco. It still just blows my mind. So the biggest thank you ever from Australia. And I'm going to take a photo of the information Becky gave me. So you'll see it, the white railing fence. The house has a blue roof, like a bright blue roof, something blue that Becky had mentioned, and the bush with the pink flowers. You couldn't get much more specific than that, and that's exactly where I found her. I still get goosebumps just thinking about it. So this is my testimonial. Becky is the real deal, and she was just incredible and helped me in the middle of the night here in Australia to find this beautiful mama cat who has gone for a wander. There she is. Thanks again, Becky. Thanks from Australia. Thanks from Coco. I'm sure she's happy. She's well fed now. And she'll have some beautiful babies. Thank you.